TV2, Detroit.
Tonight, the Operation Primetime stations present Irwin Shaw's The Top of the Hill.
No more cars. No more planes. No more crazy chances. Michael, I'm not going to help you kill yourself.
Take your hands off.
Oh, mister, you made a big mistake.
Michael! Look who's back in town.
How about Norma?
You married?
Yeah, I'm married. We're kind of separated right now.
I'll drink to that.
My wife, Mr. Stone, tells me that she's persuaded you to stay on here as a skiing instructor.
But skiing's not your profession, is it?
I see you two have met.
Come, sit by me.
Special name when it comes to men's formal wear. President Tuxedo. Why? Perhaps the styles. Always appropriate. Perhaps the selection. Yves Saint Laurent, Lord West, Pierre Cardin. President Tuxedo. No more expensive, but much more distinctive. For your wedding, formal occasion, or just a night on the town. Consider President Tuxedo. There's one near you.
If you are thinking about buying central air conditioning this year, think twice. An air conditioner can do only one job. But the energy-efficient electric heat pump does two. Added to your present forced air furnace, it cools your home in summer and helps heat it in winter to save oil or natural gas and cut your fuel bills.
So,
think twice. The heat pump cools your home and heats it too, with plenty of available energy from Detroit Edison. Ask Detroit Edison how energy plus the heat pump can help keep the power in your hands.
Well, partner, our future's riding on this proposal.
Express Mail knows it doesn't matter how great your proposal is if it's late. That's why your postal service created Express Mail. Next day delivery to many major cities. Your package gets special attention to assure on-time overnight delivery.
Hello.
We got it. We got it.
Express Mail will make you an overnight success. See the yellow pages under Air Cargo for your nearest Express Mail post office.
They call him a White House Romeo, a young Errol Flynn. He's the president's son on the rebound from a disastrous divorce. In this week's Star, you'll learn how Chip Carter's conduct enraged the president. Get Chip's amorous exploits in the Star this week. The Star also tells how Kenny Rogers' fight to the top killed three marriages. reveals the overweight champ and gives you 101 simple money-saving tips like these from Heloise, plus the private lives of the wild and wacky stars of TV's Dallas. Join the 12 million readers in The Star this week.
What?
The last time I'm going to watch you do anything. Michael, I thought you were going to hit.
I haven't hit before, have I?
That's not funny. What did you think you were doing?
Flying?
You waited so long before you opened the chute. Suppose something...
Suppose. Don't suppose. Felt terrific.
Not to me.
You know what it was like up there? Complete freedom. Amazing. Nothing holding you down.
Nothing holding you up.
Maybe you ought to try it sometime.
You're kidding.
This, what the hell were you trying up there, Mr. Stone? I told you to open that chute at 2,500 feet.
I was close.
Close, hell. You were below 1,000 and dropping like a rock when I lost sight of you.
One of the best jumps I ever had.
Really? Well, I'm glad to hear that, Mr. Stone, because it's the last one you're ever going to have on this field.
Hey, come on.
No, come on yourself. I have yet to lose a jumper, and I'm not about to start with you. If you hit the ground at that speed, Mr. Stone, that's pretty messy. I don't want to have to clean up after you.
Hey, McCain, I was in control all the way.
Except you didn't do what I told you, and I told you 2,500 feet. Now, you want to play Russian roulette? That's fine.
But you get some other damn fool to take you up. Goodbye, Mr. Stone.
What do I owe you?
Nothing. Nothing. Last one's on me.
Well, does that make you happy?
Not happy. Just less nervous. Let's go home. Michael, if you're so bored with me, why don't you say so?
What are you talking about?
Us. You and me. The way you act, the things you do. As though you don't care anymore if you live or die.
Hey, listen, what I was doing up there wasn't that dangerous.
You jumped out of an airplane.
You know what I mean.
No, I don't. Not anymore. I don't think you do either.
Look, we've been over all this before. I told you. It makes me feel good. It makes me feel alive. Not like some robot in a three-piece suit sitting in an air-conditioned office where you gotta throw a bomb against the window if you want to find out what the weather's like outside.
Let's go home.
Makes a pretty good martini. Come on in, the water's fine.
I am in. I'm sorry I was in such a lousy mood.
I think you forgot something.
What?
A bathing suit.
Well, now that you mention it.
Mm. Hi, Karen.
Oh, good morning, Mr. Stone. Look, there's some messages that just came in for you, and there's a list of calls on your desk. And Mr. Mitchell's on his way over. Tough weekend?
The weekends are never tough. It's just Monday through Friday.
It's a hard life. You want a cup of coffee?
Hey, did anybody ever tell you maybe you should be a nurse?
That's what all the boys say.
And when Tokyo came out with that new data link-up system at damn near half our cost, it really cut the legs out from under the whole instrument division. It's all in the report to the board.
Mitch, I read the report. You address the questions very well, but you don't give us any answers. Do you realize that your division is the only one in the entire Langrock Corporation that's operating in the red?
I know, Michael. We're working on it. We've got a new miniaturization process in development that's cheap enough to get us back into the market on a competitive basis.
But when?
Well, we should be in production sometime in the second quarter next year.
That's soon enough.
Look, Michael, I know I'm in trouble, but Langrock only looks at the fact sheets. He doesn't know the problems we've had.
Mitch, that's what Langrock is supposed to do. Read the fact sheets. That's his job. The job of the board of directors, that's all they know. They see the facts. They don't want to know about the problems. And the same with the stockholders. We have a responsibility to the stockholders. We have got to tell them something positive.
I can't tell them what isn't true. I can't make it happen overnight. Nobody can.
Okay. I'm going to give it my best shot, but no guarantees. And you're going to have to do something for me. You have got to get those engineers to work fast. Understand?
I'll do the best I can. You know that.
Thanks for coming by.
All right. Look. I thought I was going to get the axe this morning. I was up half the night thinking about it. Too old to get another job, too young to retire. Not that I can afford. Michael, thanks, sir. You know what I mean.
Karen, tell Mr. Langrock I'd like to see him as soon as possible.
Another chance? To do what? Lose another $14 million? Now, Michael, you know as well as I do that division's a disaster.
Frank, listen, I think he's on the verge of pulling it together.
You think? Well, that's not good enough. Though the man is just not up to the job, Michael. Any damn fool can see that.
Listen, they're working on a new miniaturization process.
Get rid of him. Now, Michael, I want Mitchell's desk cleared by lunchtime. You know, you've come a long way in the last few years. This is no time to get soft.
You know me better than that, Frank. I leave my heart at home every morning.
Get out of here. Oh, listen. See if they've straightened out that valve problem in the fluid system division.
I'm already on it.
I figured you would be.
Oh, Mr. Mitchell, go right in. He's expecting you.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, Mitch.
Shot you down, huh?
Yep.
I was afraid of that. He wants my head, huh?
Could you have your office cleaned out this morning?
That fast?
By noon.
You know how many years I've been with this company?
18. And I get an hour.
Mitch, don't make it any tougher than it already is.
You're my hero. Thanks, Eric. I know you tried.
Good luck.
On the line from New York.
Barry, how are you? Yeah, you know, because we got some critical dates to meet on that isolation system, and if we don't meet them, you know, who's going to be down your throat and mine too? Go ahead, let me hear it.
You look good. You look better than good. You look great. What'd you do, lose weight or is
Bobby,
it the suit?
Bobby.
It's a sure thing, man.
Sounds familiar.
I know. But this time it's different. I mean it.
How much you in the hole?
Don't ask. But this can get me out. Anyway, I'll always pay you back. Eventually.
Bobby, how much?
$1,000.
$1,000? Make it $500.
Done. Bobby, Antoine.
I know, I spelled it before.
Oh, tear it out, quick. There. Just talk. Act real natural, will you? Just talk to me like you're holding a regular conversation. Hi.
I know that grin. What are you up to?
We were just talking about you.
Are you loaning him money?
Boy, are you suspicious? I mean, we were just sitting here saying what a wonderful person you were and just talking about you.
Michael, if you're helping him gamble...
Look, it was a sure thing. Tell her, see if she'll believe you.
All right. I know you're going to think I'm crazy, but I can't lose this. I absolutely cannot lose this.
You never can, and you always do. You know, one time we were on tour in this little town, no horses, no bookies, no gambling. You know where I found him? Playing bingo with little old ladies. Told me he was going to church.
I did. They had a game in the basement. How about a song?
We don't have time.
Sure we do. Come on, sweetheart.
Come on, this one.
I'm as soft a touch as you are.
Who can resist me? Come on. What do you want to do?
Baltimore Oriole. Yeah.
Send her back home.
nice when you smile.
It's nice when I'm with you.
Let's go.
Penny.
Not worth it.
Something happened today?
Oh, the same routine, maybe a little worse.
What?
Langrock gave me the privilege of firing one of the few really nice guys in the company. I gotta tell you, it wasn't a whole lot of fun.
Oh, I'm sorry. That must feel terrible.
Goes with the paycheck.
I didn't marry you for your paycheck.
No, you didn't.
You know who called me today, out of the blue? Barney Bloom. He wanted to know if I wanted to go on the road. He needs an opening act.
And did you pack your bags?
No, I told him I was still happily married and very retired. But it was nice to be asked. Gone, but not forgotten. At least not by my old manager.
Good night, Barney Bloom, wherever you are.
You could do the same thing, you know.
What?
Quit the business. Quit the Langrock Corporation, anyway. We don't have to live the way we do, Michael. And you can get another job, maybe for not as much money, but... that job has been eating away at you for months. I'd rather have you happy than rich. You know I mean that.
I know you're terrific.
And?
And I love you.
Well, you can tell me about that in detail when we get home.
Is that a promise?
To the show?
Lose weight? Control yourself. Cindy, overweight? Control yourself with the Control Diet Plan. Control contains nothing but a clinically proven weight loss ingredient and not a speck of stimulant. So just one capsule can help you stick to your diet all day long. Ellen?
I've got Control.
Cindy?
Nope. I'm losing weight with Control.
Want to lose weight without stimulants? Control yourself.
They call him a White House Romeo, a young Errol Flynn. He's the president's son on the rebound from a disastrous divorce. In this week's Star, you'll learn how Chip Carter's conduct enraged the president. Get Chip's amorous exploits in the Star this week. The Star also tells how Kenny Rogers' fight to the top killed three marriages. reveals the overweight champ and gives you 101 simple money-saving tips like these from Heloise, plus the private lives of the wild and wacky stars of TV's Dallas. Join the 12 million readers in The Star this week.
Detroit has five seasons, June, July, August, winter, and changeable.
Dummy, come on, man.
Yeah,
in the winter.
You should see the weather reports on TV2. Eyewitness News.
TV2?
Yeah, TV2 now has a weatherman who shows the latest satellite weather information and illustrates it so that everyone can understand.
Terrific.
They have the newest digital color radar that shows local weather right now.
When's he on?
5:30, 6 and 11.
Don't you
miss it. Well, I'll be so good.
Good.
The look of Detroit, TV2, Eyewitness News. The look of a city on the moon.
They said he's all right. Let me go check. It's going to be okay.
Though. I've been wanting to get a new car. Maybe I'll get one of those turbo Porsches.
Michael, when I heard that announcement...
Oh, come on. They said I was okay.
After a lifetime.
I gotta tell you something. It's really terrific out there, though. Nothing like it.
You liked it?
Liked it? Oh, you kidding? Boy, for those few seconds, that's real excitement.
Michael, coming that close to dying isn't excitement. It's insanity. I thought you were dead. Don't you understand that?
What's the matter with you? In those few seconds, didn't you feel something really different? Huh?
Michael, you're crazy.
Hey, I like the way I felt. I mean, why should I lie about it?
Stop it! I don't want to hear you say that!
Listen to me a second. I gotta do it. It's what makes me feel alive.
What the hell do you think you're doing? You didn't have to cut me off.
Man, I didn't cut you off. I gave you plenty of room.
Dumb jerk, you almost killed the both of us.
Hey, listen, I'll tell you what you do. The next time you see me coming up behind you, you just get out of the way, huh?
Yeah, I'll get out of your way. Like this.
Thank you.
told me you took the car.
I didn't want to see you.
Yeah, I kind of figured that out.
Michael, the way you were acting, you scared me.
So you just took off, huh? Terrific.
I heard how the accident happened.
Yeah, from whom?
Joe Archer. He was right there at turn six. He said there was no way you could have made it. You took a crazy chance.
He doesn't know nothing. Nothing. I didn't take any chance.
You know what I think? I think you did it just to take the chance. Just to see how far you could push it, the same way you waited so long to open your parachute.
Hey, you know, you really don't know what you're talking about. You don't.
Michael, maybe you don't know it. You're trying to kill yourself.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
You act as though risking your life is some kind of game. I'm not going to stand around and watch. Today finished it for me.
Finished what?
I don't want to be there when it happens.
Wait a minute. What do you mean by that?
Michael, I can't talk to you anymore. You just stand there and then go out and do whatever it is you want to do. Don't risk us. Don't take a chance on that.
Oh, don't worry. I don't think there'd be much of a thrill. Hey, wait, listen, look.
Your passport's up to date.
Why?
We just closed the Hoffman Brower deal.
Congratulations.
54% of the biggest industrial electrical supply company in Western Europe. Not a bad acquisition, huh? Now, I want you on a plane to Germany in 10 days at the outside, then Zurich, Paris, London. Let them all know that we're running things from here on out. Research is already working on it, and you are going to have some very tough questions to ask, my friend.
Okay.
Okay. You don't sound very enthusiastic. You know, this is a choice assignment, Michael. A lot of men in this company would leap at it. But I thought you'd do the best job. Maybe I was wrong.
What do you want me to say, Frank? Whoopee?
I don't like your attitude, Michael.
I guess I'm just a little on edge.
You better think it over and then come to me and tell me convincingly how much you want this assignment. Understand?
I got the picture.
I wouldn't let too much time go by, Michael.
Was it something I said or something I played? I mean, you walk in here and you don't even say hello?
Hello.
Look, Michael, if you're mad at me about the money, I thought that
better. Bobby, I'm not mad at you.
What is it?
Go play the piano, huh?
You having a problem with Elizabeth?
Right now, I'm having a problem with just about everybody. Play me a song, will you?
You don't mind if I take a break, do you? Now I mingle with the clientele and let them tell me how wonderful I am. I'll see you in a while, okay?
Friend of yours?
Usually.
But not tonight?
Tonight is not one of my more sensational nights.
Yes, I know what that's like. I've been there once or twice. I have found that usually the best thing is to find something else to think about.
You got any suggestions?
Well, you could start by offering to buy me another drink.
You haven't finished the one you got? Lou, bring the lady another drink.
The lady's name is Josie.
Hi, Josie. Meet Michael.
Michael. I think you're a lady killer, Michael.
Wrong. All the ladies I know are alive and healthy.
That's reassuring. And what do you do, Michael, for a living?
Add and subtract.
Numbers?
People.
Oh, that's interesting. And what would you say I am, Michael? Plus or minus?
I don't know. I don't make quick decisions.
I can't help it. I've got to have the money. You're going to have to come up with the money.
I'm going to come up with the money.
I can't wait any longer.
I just need a little more time.
Yes, you ask for more time, but you never pay me.
Yeah, but you know I'm good for it. I just want another week or so.
Excuse me. Bobby, has got a friend of yours?
Stay out of this, Michael.
This is a private conversation. You mind?
I don't mind. So why don't you take your hands off?
Michael, stay out of this!
You heard him.
Take your hands off.
Oh, mister, you made a big mistake.
Michael!
Now, next time it's going to be worse. And you're going to be playing piano with your elbows. Now, that you can bet on.
Michael. God, I told you to stay out of it, Michael.
Dr. Curtis, please call 104 West. Dr. Curtis.
Better than last night. You should be asking about the other guy.
That's not funny.
Listen, you're supposed to humor the patient. If you don't laugh at his jokes, at least smile.
Well, you were lucky. The doctor says it's just a mild concussion and a minor rib separation.
He was a professional. He knew what he was doing.
I need to talk to you.
Go ahead. I'm not going anywhere. Hey, listen, did you get the mail? That registered letter I asked you about? Huh. Montreal. Think they'd have one closer than that.
On what?
Turbo Porsche. You know, I was always interested in one. Now that the old car's wrecked, well, I just thought I'd look into it. Listen, I tell you what I want you to do. When you get home, I want you to call him.
No. No more cars. No more planes. No more crazy chances. Michael, I'm not going to help you kill yourself. I may not be able to stop you, but I'm not going to help you.
Come on. Don't start up with me again about that.
Please. I'm not starting. Finishing. Getting into a bar fight. How could you? What were you thinking? What were you trying to prove? That you're indestructible? You're not.
Came close.
When you first started doing all those crazy things, maybe I should have tried to stop you. But I knew how you were feeling. I knew how your job was just swallowing you up, and you wanted to break free whenever you could. It was never enough. You had to push it and push it and push it until everything was another death-defying act by Michael Stone. And then I just prayed that it was some kind of premature midlife crisis. Michael, that's not it. I can't talk to you anymore. I don't know who you are. I can't take it.
What are you trying to tell me?
I need time. I need time away from you. I love you. But I can't spend my life waiting for you to kill yourself.
When I get out of here, we get home. You and me, we're going to sit down. We're going to talk
about... No. No more talking, Michael. You can't talk me out of it. I called Barney and I told him I wanted to go on the road again. I'm leaving for Denver this afternoon.
This afternoon? Denver? What the hell are you going to do there?
I have to go, Michael. I just have to.
Oh, you have to go. You have to go. That's easy. I mean, that explains everything.
You have no right to be angry at me.
The hell I don't. You're walking out on me.
Well, you know how to get me back. If you want to find me, Barney will know how to reach me.
Great.
Bye, Michael.
Bunny quits. Well, that sure is hair-raising news. But I know that you'll be having some fun if you watch this funny, truly exciting, and heartwarming story to see if anyone can make Jack change his mind. I mean, hey, could there really be a last Easter egg?
Friday night at 7:30.
You're feeling good.
You're feeling good about yourself. You're drinking Diet Pepsi Cola with just one calorie and that great honest to Pepsi taste. And it shows in the way you look, the way you feel, and in everything you do.
And you're drinking one calorie Diet Pepsi. Yeah, you're drinking one calorie Diet Pepsi. And it shows.
They're the tops. They're the upper stratas. They're the jeans with the social status. Girls with private jets and with fancy pets think they're tops. They're caviar. They're for girls who have chauffeured caddies. They're for girls blessed with wealthy daddies. They're the jeans that fit when you stand or sit. They don't stop because Gloria Vanderbilt bottoms all the top.
By Marjani.
At Hudson's.
Who can pick up a pack of pickled peppers in Pittsburgh
and unpack it tomorrow in Portland?
Or 2 tons of toothpicks in Tucson
and take them to Tuscaloosa?
Who can pick up red sails in the Canadian sunset and deliver them before the moon comes over Miami? Or take blueprints from Brownsville all the way to Green Bay?
The answer to any shipping riddle is Emery. We've flown more packages to more places overnight than anyone else.
Or machine parts from Buffalo
to where the deer and the antelope play.
Emery. From here to there, overnight.
Look, Michael, I'm sorry I didn't visit you in the hospital, but they're really depressed.
Well, the least you could do is give me a hand with his bag.
You know, those bright lights and white uniforms, I find them very unnerving for someone who plays a piano in a cave all his life.
Huh? Just do me a favor, huh? Don't be so colorful.
Hey.
Well, Gilbert, this is Michael Stone. I'm calling about the car. Well, I expect to be in Montreal shortly. I'd like to see the car then. If I like it, I'll take it. Yes. Yes, thank you very much. Don't worry, this won't take long. I came to tell you that I'm not going to Europe for you.
You interrupted this meeting for that?
No, I interrupted the meeting to tell you that I'm quitting.
I'll see you in 30 minutes, Michael.
No, you won't, Frank. You'll never see me again. Not if I have anything to do with it.
Michael!
Don't worry. I'll have the desk cleaned out by noon.
Just like that?
Yep.
You think that's a little extreme?
No.
Michael, what are you gonna do?
Buy a car?
Yeah, okay. I've heard of people buying a car before, but they don't quit their jobs.
Elizabeth always wanted me to quit.
But you're going to Montreal, not Denver. That doesn't make any sense.
I know. When I find out what does, I'll let you know. Come on, let's go.
Michael, what about Elizabeth? If she calls, what am I gonna tell her?
You'll think of something. Look, Bobby, she wanted me to change my life. That's what I'm trying to do.
Montreal.
No, Lake Placid's nearby. When I was a kid, I grew up there. I was a ski instructor.
Oh, great. I'll tell her you've gone to the Olympics.
Lake Placid. You know, there was a whole world out there then. It was simple. All I had to do was reach out and grab it. Maybe I grabbed the wrong thing. Tell her that I love her, will you?
She knows that, Michael.
I'll tell her anyway.
You gonna hear from you?
Sure. When I get there, I'll call.
You know, for three people who like each other so much, we sure have a tough time staying together.
Bobby, I gotta go.
All right, from one nut to another, don't do anything crazy.
Specifications match exactly those in your inquiries. We could, of course, do the modifications you ask about, but that would take a little time.
No.
But on the phone you said...
I know what I said. I'll take it just like it is.
Very good, Mr. Stone.
United States.
Do you have anything to declare for U.S. Customs?
No, sir, I don't.
You may proceed. If you're traveling south, take it easy. Weather reports a heavy snowstorm ahead.
Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
I'll be halfway to Florida by the time we get turned around. This is 32J. Some joker in a turbo Porsche just shot past us like a rocket. 157 and change. See if you can scoop him up. We sure can't.
When I think of Canada, I think of salmon and lobsters and sweet corn. And the best beer I ever tasted, Labatt's.
Labatt's, the good taste of Canada beer.
Of course, here at home, the food is just as great. So is the beer. Now that Labatt's is imported.
When you think of Canada,
think of Labatt's.
Hey, Richie.
Yep.
How much you make a week?
Same as you.
$385. Think you're gonna be making over $800 a week 4 years from now?
$800 a week? No way.
You better tell that to the Democrats. If inflation stays the way it is now, and the Democrats stay in control of Congress another 4 years, you have to double your paycheck just to live the way you live now. Think you'll make it?
No way.
There's one way. Vote Republican. For a change.
If it's been a while since you've eaten crab legs, let Red Lobster remind you how. Uh-huh. Right in the middle. That's right. It pays to dig deep. Oh. Dip that sweet, delicate meat into rich melted butter. Ah, there you go. Now, if you'd like more practice, we know where you can get plenty. Red Lobster's serving them tonight. Lots of them.
Red Lobster for the seafood lover in you.
Martha Jean is the queen in Detroit, and she holds court as we look at religion in the 80s.
Emmanuel Stewart is the king of boxing, and he handles talents like Tommy Hearns and Helmer Kente. He also convinced several boxers not to go on that ill-fated plane which crashed en route to Poland.
And Arthur Jefferson has problems inside his schoolrooms, inside his school budgets, and inside the tax assessor's office.
These stories and more coming up tomorrow at 8 on Good Morning Detroit.
Out of the car.
Answer a couple of cars.
All right, get those cars off the highway.
You were kind of a hurry, weren't you, mister?
John, take a look at the car. Driver's license, registration. California driver's license. Temporary Canadian registration.
I just bought the car today.
Where were you taking it?
I don't know. I hadn't decided.
Is there anything in the car, John?
Nothing.
You wouldn't be wanted for anything, would you, mister?
Because I sure got this funny feeling that you're running away from something. Nothing illegal, Sergeant.
Well, maybe we just ought to check on that. Where'd you buy the car?
Montreal.
Oh, you came from Montreal. You don't know where you're going. You're in one hell of a hurry to get there.
You know, we clocked you at 157 miles per hour. Do you know what that is? That's 102 miles per hour over the speed limit. Well, I guess I just kind of got carried away.
Carried away?
Yeah.
Start moving fast. There are going to be a lot of people standing up at the Olympics. I can't build those grandstands overnight.
As soon as I hear something, Mr. Ellsworth, I'll let you know.
Yes,
sir.
See what you can do, Ralph. I'll be back. Michael Stone. Book him and check him through Albany.
Hello, George.
Yeah, how are you, Herb?
Keeping busy. What's this criminal done?
Well, that's what we're about to find out. I picked him up going down a highway at better than 150.
I'm not surprised.
Well, you know him?
Hello, Herb. I always figured you'd come back for a visit, Michael. But not like this.
Why didn't you say you were from around here?
It's been a long time. Too long. George, take those things off him.
Well, if you vouch for him, Herb, I guess it's okay. But there's still that little matter of the ticket to pay. And that's not going to be cheap. $500.
Some things don't change, I guess, huh?
Oh, we've got plenty of changes around here. Hotels, restaurants, a whole bunch of new houses down by the lake. People are the same, though. You seem to be doing all right.
It depends on how you look at it. What do you say, Herb? Come on, I'll buy you a cup of coffee.
If you can still afford it.
Getting ready for the Olympics is making it all busy now. But I've had more than I can handle for years. Remember that area a couple miles north of your Mirror Mountain?
Oh, sure.
Best skiing around. Built a whole French ski village out there. Beautiful lodge and everything. They opened about a year and a half ago. I guess they're doing all right. A fellow named Hegener.
You know, Herb, it's strange coming back here. It really is.
15 years, Michael.
Yeah.
Norma's married, you know.
Oh, yeah?
It wasn't that long after you left. It kind of took everybody by surprise. You remember Dave Cully. He was an instructor with you.
Torma married Dave Cully? Well, he was always stuck on her.
She was stuck on you. Till you vanished. What made you decide to come back?
A roadblock. I didn't have any place to end up. No plans.
Well, you can sure plan on coming to dinner tonight. 8 o'clock?
I'll be there. Say, can you tell me a good place to stay around here?
Where else? Mirror Mountain.
Is the lake frozen?
3 feet thick. What are you going to do? Take the old shortcut?
Why not? I think I remember the way.
Yes, I will take care of that. All right. Thank you very much. Can I help you?
Yes, please. My name is Stone. I believe Herb Ellsworth called.
Yes, Mr. Michael Stone?
Yes, you do have a room, don't you?
Oh, yes, yes. Number 206. I will send somebody for your luggage.
Thank you. My car's right out front and the keys are in it.
Yes, I know which one it is. I saw you drive across the lake. A rather unusual approach, wouldn't you say, Mr. Stone?
It is for some people.
Well, enjoy your stay.
Thank you.
If you would sign in, please.
Operator? Yes. Long distance. Hello. Yes. Area code 213. The number 555-1370. Thank you.
Michael, where are you? No, Michael, I haven't heard from you yet. Hey, listen, Michael, how do I get there? Yeah, I gotta leave town. Your little fight got me fired. You gotta find me a job.
Find you a job? Listen, I'll tell you what I want you to do. You call Barney Bloom's office and leave this number so in case Elizabeth calls, all right?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
The number here is 437-2368. Yeah, you got it?
Okay. How do you like it there? You gonna stay?
Yeah, it's not bad. It's pretty nice here.
Sure you don't want me to call Elizabeth?
Listen, don't you call her, okay?
Okay.
I'll talk to you when you get here. Good. Bye-bye.
Hegner would like to invite you to have a drink with her.
Oh, that's very nice. When?
She's waiting in the bar. Right this way.
Mrs. Hegner?
Sit down, Mr. Stone. Oh, Rita, another glass and a bottle of the 74, please. Well, you seem surprised.
Well, to tell you the truth, I am a little bit.
Thought I was a desk clerk. Not very flattering, Mr. Stone. Not very flattering at all.
Well, you have my sincere apology.
That won't be necessary. How do you like Mirror Mountain so far?
Let's say it's growing on.
How long do you plan to stay?
Well, I don't have any plans to go anywhere else.
Well, that's good. You ski, of course.
Well, I used to ski around here years ago.
Well, you're then on familiar grounds. That's fine. Mr. Stone will pour Rita. All right?
Sure. Your pleasure.
Mm-hmm. Austrian, we have quite a good cellar here.
I'll have to sample it sometime. Cheers.
Was it?
It's very nice.
Thank you. I was admiring your car.
So is your dog.
Well, you noticed? I hope you're not offended.
I didn't take it personally. It's a beautiful dog. Very nice.
My husband's.
He's a man of obvious good taste.
Would you like to have dinner with me tonight, Mr. Stone?
I'd love to have dinner with you. Unfortunately, I can't, though. Herb Ellsworth invited me. I haven't seen him in a long time.
Another night, then.
Good night, and thank you for the drink. I hope you'll let me return the favor sometime.
We'll see.
My Henry needs a new flea collar. Which do you recommend?
Let me tell you about flea and tick collars, ma'am.
Henry should see this.
Some kill fleas and ticks like a powder, others like a spray. Only one works both ways. Sentry 5 from Sargent's works like a powder and a spray.
Which would you like, Henry? Henry says he wants this one.
For your dog or cat, get the only collar that works like a powder and a spray. The Sargent's Sentry 5 collar.
7 p.m. PM Magazine on the scene. Wednesday.
What does the CIA have to do with gourmet food? This CIA is the Culinary Institute of America, and it attracts students from around the world who want to learn the secrets of the finest master chefs. We'll visit this unique school on our next PM Magazine. Chef Tell makes mouth-watering Austrian pancakes, and Joyce Kilhaywick discovers the latest in wild inventions.
Tomorrow at 7 p.m.
Together with the Loop of Detroit.
Thank you.
Michael, come on in. Like old times, right on time. Minna?
Michael! Oh, let me look at you. You're just the same as ever. Come on in and tell us all about everything.
Well, honey, give him a chance to get comfortable first.
Just as I remember it.
Well, everything we have is turning into an antique, except the TV set.
What are you drinking these days, Michael?
Oh, whatever you have in her.
That must be Norma and Dave. I'll get it.
Herb told you that they were married. Well, Norma is... never mind.
Well, look who's back in town.
Hello, Norma. Dave, how you doing? Good to see you again.
Long time.
Yeah.
Get me a drink, will you?
Sure. I'll get ours, Michael.
I don't want to burn the roast.
Look at you. All grown up.
I was grown up then. Now I'm just getting old.
Oh, come on. You look terrific.
Like hell I do.
You're still the terror of the slopes?
No, I haven't skated in years. Besides, you were the terror.
Thanks,
Did you put water in this?
Just a splash.
Figures. You can't even make a simple drink.
Dave is head of the ski school up at Mirror Mountain.
Oh, yeah? Hey, that's a beautiful place. How long you been there, Dave?
Oh, since it opened. You staying up there?
Yeah, it's nice. By the way, I had a drink with Mrs. Hagen just before I came over here.
I hear she really runs the place. I guess she's got to, with Mr. Hagen in and out of the hospital.
What's the matter with him?
Never said.
You married?
Well, yeah.
We're kind of separated right now.
Hmm. I'll drink to that.
Norma?
He thinks I drink too much. What else is there to do in this lousy town? You bought me my first drink, Michael. You remember that?
I remember. You got sick.
Yeah. Well, I don't have that problem anymore. Dinner's ready. Oh, Herb, will you come and help me carve the roast? Come on, come on.
You see, Michael, the old one had wooden sides. This is an entire new run. It's got everything refrigerated just for the Olympics.
Dave's trying out for the American team.
Oh, yeah?
You were on the bobsled team at Cornell, weren't you?
Well, we tried. Dave, what is it, two-man or a four-man sled?
No, it's a two-man. Paul Ryan's a driver, I'm the brakeman. We've clocked some good times. It's fast. I mean, it's a lot faster now, up to 90 miles an hour.
Really?
One thing we have that's really nice, it's called Shady Corner Curve. It's a hard right. You come in.
Take me home.
Yeah, and you brace up around here.
Come on, I want to go.
I'm telling Michael about the bobsled run, Norma.
I want to go.
Herb, thanks for a nice dinner.
Don't bother to get up.
Mike? Herb? Say, Michael, I'll probably see you again sometime.
Take it easy.
All right.
of sad, Michael, wouldn't you? I can't help your own child anymore. It doesn't do any good to say it now, but I guess Norma would have been happier if she'd have gotten out of Placid and made a life for herself somewhere. The way she skied, I always thought she'd go on tour. Probably would have made the women's team.
Herb, she was a magnificent skier.
Yeah. I better see how Minna's doing in the kitchen.
Hey, that was some run.
Are you enjoying your visit at Muir Mountain, Mr. Stone?
Sure, Aunt. You're terrific.
Maria's gonna win the downhill. You wait and see.
Oh, yeah? You're on the Olympic team?
Well, not yet. The final selections won't be coming out for a couple of weeks.
You'll make it. I know she will.
I wish I had her confidence. Hey, listen, would you like to ski with us?
I'd love to. I don't think I'm in your class. Some other time, though. Thanks. Mrs. Hagen.
Did you have a nice day?
One of the best.
I watched you, and you do ski very well.
Oh, thank you. I'm a little rusty, but I'll get there.
I'm sure you will. I have heard that you were an instructor once.
When I was a kid, free skiing.
We could use another instructor here.
You're not offering me a job, are you?
What I'm offering you is free skiing. Look, think it over. I'm sure we can arrange some kind of schedule that wouldn't be too inconvenient for you. Oh, I live right over there, in case you should ever want to find me.
I'll know where to look.
I certainly hope so.
Room 206? Yeah. Thanks. Say, where'd you learn how to ski like that?
Here. I've been here since I was three.
Hey, did you ever try to race?
Well, have you ever heard of a black downhill racer?
No, but then never heard of a black professional baseball player either until Jackie Robinson broke into the majors.
Yeah. Well, my father thinks that it'll take another 50 years. And in 50 years, I'll be 66. And how many girls in the Olympics do you know of who are 66?
Come to think of it, none.
So.
Hi, honey.
I'll be home in 20 minutes. Yeah? Why don't you take some aspirin? Just lie down and relax, and I'll pick up some dinner on the way home. Yeah. But come on, honey. You've got to eat something.
Bunny quits. Well, that sure is hair-raising news. But I know that you'll be having some fun if you watch this funny, truly exciting, and heartwarming story to see if anyone can make Jack change his mind. I mean, hey, could there really be a last Easter egg?
Friday night at 7:30. From the TV2 Eyewitness Newsroom, this is Newsbreak brought to you by Honey Radio AM 56.
Iran's President Bonnie Sadr says his government plans to take the Americans away from the militants. And President Carter says he plans to delay any retaliatory measures against Iran because of those latest developments. Michigan residents are being warned to delay trips to New York City because of a huge mass transit strike there.
Who put the bomb in the bomb?
Detroit's only all oldies station, Honey Radio, AM 56. Listen.
I'm Robbie Timmons. More news tonight at 11.
This news break has been brought to you by Honey Radio, AM 56.
Seems like it's already been
getting faster.
Hey, how you doing?
Good. So you made it down the hill?
Yeah, it wasn't easy, though. You know, the wheels, legs, very tired. Listen, would you like to join me?
Yeah, sure. First time skiing this year?
Well, first time in a lot of years.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Well, I used to work for a living.
And now you don't?
And now I don't. By the way, my name's Michael Stone.
I know. Rita told me.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. I'm Maria Van Thau.
Hi, Maria. How you doing?
Good.
Listen, can I get you a drink? A refill?
Nah. In training.
Orange juice, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Let me have a scotch and soda in a short glass.
Buy you a drink?
Not now, Bob. Look, I'm busy.
All right.
Catch you later, okay?
Okay.
Thanks. Put it on my tab. You know, for a minute there, I thought maybe I'd lost you. Friend of yours?
Well, just someone I know. I know a lot of people. Most of them try too hard.
I'll try to keep that in mind. What do you do besides skiing?
Nothing. There's no time for anything else.
What about after the Olympics?
Well, that depends. I don't make plans, do you?
I don't make plans anymore.
I didn't think so.
Listen, they're going to run some bobsleds tomorrow over at the Olympic Run. Have you seen that before?
Yeah, I've been there a few times.
How about it? Want to go tomorrow?
Why, are you going?
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, gee, what time is it?
A little after 7.
I've got to go. But maybe I'll see you there tomorrow.
Okay, good.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Do I have a refill?
Michael!
Bobby!
Hey! How you doing?
Good, terrific. When'd you get in?
Just now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Good flight?
It was all right. I asked for you at the desk, and this gorgeous girl tells me you're in town. You don't waste any time, do you, pal? Huh? Hey, a piano, huh? You told him I was coming.
Told who?
My employers.
Oh, I haven't gotten around to it yet.
Oh, Michael. Now, Michael, you really disappoint me.
I'm working on it.
Well, you better work on it soon. I'm in big trouble.
Oh, yeah? Well, we'll pass the hat.
Michael, my financial difficulties are not to be taken lightly.
Since when?
Well, since my departure from Los Angeles was not exactly graceful, Michael.
You mean the big guy that liked me so much?
The big guy. And a couple of his bigger friends. Well, since you didn't tell anybody I was coming, I better show the people I'm here, huh? See you in a minute. Don't go away.
Stone. I just came by to see whether you were comfortable or needed anything.
You look in on all your guests this way?
Pour the wine, Mr. Stone. That is, if you don't mind. May I call you Michael?
What do I call you?
Eva.
Eva?
Mm-hmm.
Who's it, Eva?
Who's it? Have you thought about my offer?
Hard not to think about it.
And?
Why me?
Do you really want to know the answer to that?
Yeah, I think I do.
All right, then I tell you. The usual instructors we have here, I find their conversation limited, to say the least. Country boys beguiling only when they're going downhill. I have a feeling that your conversation would not bore me.
It's very flattering.
I'm sure you're used to flattery, Michael.
You may be overrating me.
Now, what about the job?
Why not?
Good. For the season?
Let's say for a while.
As long as it amuses you.
And you.
Please.
news is at your door every day, so you'll know what to do, what to buy,
and where you should go.
You get the best reporting of the news that is hot, more local nitty-gritty
than the other guys got.
Classifieds and coupons, features and sports.
It costs you less and gives you more
ideas of all sorts.
When you read the news, we think it will show.
If you read the news, you know.
Detroit has five seasons, June, July, August, winter, and changeable.
Dummy, come on, Mr.
Yeah, I'm
gonna win it.
You should see the weather reports on TV2, Eyewitness News.
TV2?
Yeah, TV2 now has a weatherman who shows the latest satellite weather information and illustrates it so that everyone can understand.
Terrific.
They have the newest digital color radar that shows local weather right now.
Oh, when's he on?
5:30, 6 and 11.
Don't you miss it.
Well, I'll be so good.
Cool.
The look of Detroit, TV2, Eyewitness News. The look of a city on the moon.
United Airlines announces 10,000 free round trips to be won in April.
It's United's takeoff game.
No, I never win at games.
You could with this. 10,000 free trips.
10,000? Wow.
Choose Hawaii, Florida, anywhere United flies in the U.S.
Wow.
And you can find out right now if you've won.
Wow.
Play United's takeoff game on every flight in April.
Fly the friendly sky.
Wow.
Now in the track, welcome to an afternoon sport at Mount Van Wilkenburg, the Olympic bobsled run.
Not for $1 million.
Nobody's asking you to ride in one.
You know, the way they come around there, so fast. Then they get up high, you'd swear they wouldn't make it.
You know, that's the idea, though. Try to hit the top part of the curve and then come down flat out.
Madness.
Walter's team to the line.
Michael, that's the girl last night.
Yeah, Maria.
Incredible.
I see you found your friend.
Yeah, thanks to you.
I think you could have found him on your own.
This way is much nicer.
Hey, look, here comes the next one. Pretty dangerous.
I suppose the downhill isn't.
Well, it's a different kind of risk. You get to decide how far and how fast you want to go. Here the bobsled decides. I wouldn't try it.
See? A woman of obvious discernment and perception.
I hope that's a compliment.
A compliment? My dear, that's a statement of naked admiration.
Oh, great.
Time for Walter's 108 flat.
Yay!
Clear the track. The track is clear.
Ready?
LFS.
One, two, three. Let's go.
Yay!
what's amazing to me is even after they see a terrible accident, they keep right on doing it. Why? I mean, that's like sticking your hand in a fire after you've seen someone get burned. It doesn't make any sense.
Yes, it does. The risk is what makes it exciting.
Not for me.
That's the excitement. Finding out you can do it and survive.
Do you want to survive?
Sometimes I wonder. Look, don't tempt this man. He'd play Russian roulette with a guillotine.
Really? Why?
Gambling? Living on the edge? That's what it's all about.
Wait a second. I think you've got that all backwards. It's not taking the risk. It's judging the risk and being skillful enough to overcome it. That's where the thrill is.
Got it all figured out, don't you?
Works for me.
Wait a minute. I'm the only sensible person here. I mean, if I see a risk, I turn around and go home.
Or leave town.
Then what do you do?
Well, you see, I leave as little to chance as possible. I only bet on winners. I don't always win, but I only bet on winners. Right, Mike?
Sure he does.
Watch out.
Did you see it?
Yeah, it was pretty bad. He had a concussion, fractured one leg.
You didn't know him, did you?
Well, it's a small town. Everybody knows everything. Mrs. Hegner left a message for you. She'd like for you to come for dinner at 8 o'clock.
Well, I...
Well, then you're going to be all tied up, so I would be delighted to take you any place you'd like to go tonight.
Okay, I'll meet you in the bar.
See you in the bar.
All right, have fun.
Okay, tell Mrs. Hagen I'll be there.
Oh, I don't have to tell her, Mr. Stone. She knows.
Take time out on Tuesday for Arthur Treacher's Tuesday special.
Take time out for the good things in life.
Arthur Treacher's Tuesday special. Our original tasty fish and chips, coleslaw, two hush puppies, and a regular-sized drink, all for one low price. Every Tuesday, get a real deal on a complete meal at Arthur Treacher's, but only on Tuesdays, when it's really special.
Arthur Treacher's Seafood Restaurant.
Mr. Merritt, my Henry needs a new flea collar. Which do you recommend?
Let me tell you about flea and tick collars, ma'am.
Henry should see this.
Some kill fleas and ticks like a powder, others like a spray. Only one works both ways. Sentry 5 from Sargent's works like a powder and a spray.
Which would you like, Henry? Henry says he wants this one.
For your dog or cat, get the only collar that works like a powder and a spray. The Sargent's Sentry 5 collar.
When you're looking for help with your lawn, look to the leader, Lawn Chief Power Mowers from True Value Hardware Stores. Lawn Chief Power Mowers are engineered, tested, and produced in our modern factory with safety and dependability in mind. Each one delivers top value and performance and meets or exceeds OPEI safety standards. Lawn Chief Mowers have earned the Good Housekeeping Seal, and they are available only at participating True Value Hardware Stores and Home Centers.
It's your accountant.
My accountant? My accountant's going to be here to help me with my tax audit.
It's long distance, Walter, from Philadelphia.
Long distance? What's going on in Philadelphia?
Since the Constitution was signed, nothing.
Tonight, Walter's tax auditor is a man from Maud's past at 11:30 on your TV2. Anything but tranquilizer. Right on, Maud.
Mr. Stone?
Yes.
I'm Andreas Hegener. Please come in.
Thank you. Beautiful house you have here.
Thank you. What may I offer you to drink? We're having wine with dinner.
Oh, I think I'll just wait then.
As you wish. My wife, Mr. Stone, tells me that she's persuaded you to stay on here as a skiing instructor. But skiing's not your profession, is it?
No, it certainly isn't. No, thanks. I don't smoke.
And if I may ask, what is?
I was an executive with the Langrock Corporation.
Oh, Frank Langrock?
Right.
Very powerful man, I've heard. I never had the pleasure of meeting him.
Well, it's not much of a pleasure.
Good. I see you two have met. Come. Sit by me.
Mr. Stone was just telling me about his job.
Former job, dear. He works for us now.
Well, I don't think we can call that work, can we, Mr. Stone? Skiing is one of man's greatest pleasures. One which, unfortunately, I can no longer enjoy.
That's only because you've been very ill, dear.
A rather curious irony, Mr. Stone. What you see here at Mirror Mountain is a dream. A dream that I've had for years. A dream that was realized at considerable financial risk. Yet I'm denied everything it has to offer.
It's too bad.
Too bad. Yes, too bad.
Only because the doctor told you not to ski hardly means being denied everything.
More than enough. Doctors, Mr. Stone, are men who tell you not to do anything you might possibly enjoy.
Andreas.
All right. Come. Let us have dinner. My wife, Mr. Stone, is an excellent cook, as you shall see.
Mrs. Hegener does everything quite well, wouldn't you say?
Here are gentle. Not like the harshness of Europe. The Alps often dwindle the men who dwell in its valleys. But I'm becoming a bore.
Not at all.
Eva? I think we should have a cognac.
You know what the doctor said, Andreas?
Yes, I know. But the choice remains mine. What your soul tells you is good for you, or what some man in a white coat who knows nothing of souls tells you is bad for you. Tonight, my soul has the better argument. The cognac, Liebchen.
All right.
Mr. Stone, I have tuberculosis. A disease that modern medicine has supposedly conquered. That makes me a medical rarity, as I have the honor of being afflicted with a new and resistant strain. So far, all the doctors have been able to provide is some distinctly unpleasant treatment in the hospital. Frankly, I sometimes question whether it's worth the struggle. And if it weren't for my wife, I might gladly turn my head gently to the wall and be done with it. But Eva means a great deal to me. More than I show to anyone. More, perhaps, than I show even to her.
Here you are.
Thank you.
Andreas? Well, to the best of all possible winters.
What's it?
Joke.
Just like old times.
Why'd you come back here anyway? I mean, you don't need this job.
But I got it. They said something about picking up an instructor's emblem.
Yeah, it's in the box and your schedule's on the clipboard.
Where are you supposed to wear this thing?
Left-hand side of your coat.
Now who's joking?
That's the way your schedule came in. Mrs. Hegner's got you all booked up. You'll earn your pay, too.
How good is she?
You ought to know about that better than I do.
On skis?
On skis? Not bad. Listen, Michael, I know you can afford to take these kind of chances, but I don't want to know about it.
What about what?
I make my living in this place, and I know what's going on. Usually, they go for younger instructors.
I remember.
It may be a game to you, but it's the only kind of work I like. I don't want you to louse it up for me.
Okay.
Good.
It was some kind of spill you took the other day.
Yeah.
How's your partner?
Ah, he'll pull through in 6 months. You know all that practicing for the trials? Shot to hell.
Maybe not. You could use a new partner, couldn't you?
Yeah, it's a little late for that.
What about me?
You?
Yeah, I could be the brakeman.
You're kidding.
No.
Look, I know you've been down a run or two in your life, but bobsledding is different. How do I know you got the nerve?
Try me.
Okay, in this run, we'll take it easy.
I'll manage to hang on.
Yeah, you touch your brakes, you'll never ride with me again.
Don't worry.
Let's go.
To taste them.
Recently, Pepsi went up against Coca-Cola in side-by-side blind taste tests. Here's Paul Diamond taking the same kind of test.
Okay.
Okay, which one did you prefer?
Well, it had a more distinctive, definite taste.
You ready?
I'm ready.
You sure? Tell me what you chose.
Pepsi.
It's a fact. In tests like these, nationwide, more people prefer Pepsi over Coca-Cola.
I'm really impressed. It's a better drink.
You're taking this test, what would your choice be from now on?
Pepsi. Oh, definitely. There's no doubt in the world. And I feel as though I'm very discriminating, and I'm impressed. I'm really impressed. It was worth the hour wait out there. I'm very impressed. You know, until you compare like this, you just don't know.
Don't take our word for it. Let your taste decide. Take the Pepsi Challenge.
You believe it now that you're
saying... I believe it.
If you've never read a package in your life, read this one. It tells all about a fantastic new tampon called Rely from Procter & Gamble. It's totally different from any other tampon. See, Rely is made of two materials. Each has its own advantages, but combined, they're even better. Rely's shape is unique, too. But read the package, and I'll bet you'll never go back to what you buy now. Remember, they named it Rely.
This is Doug Podell on W4 with a 106 pack from the Jay Giles Band.
Feel what radio was meant to be. Minute after minute. Cut after cut. The ultimate musical fantasy flows free from 106. W4 at 106 FM, where Detroit rocks.
And now, a preview of the final chapter of Irwin Shaw's The Top of the Hill.
May I come in?
I don't think it's very smart.
So what?
I suppose Dave finds out.
I can do what I want to do.
Where is she, Michael? Oh, wait a minute. Norma isn't here.
She was, wasn't she? I'll tell you something. If I find out she's in your room, I'll kill you.
You see, if he would find out about us, he'd go on loving me. But you...
It's got to be sensational.
You really want to kill yourself.
Get out of here before I kill you.
You don't have the guts, do you?
It's my dream, Amy.
Well, I don't care about your dream. I'm sick and tired of your dream in these mountains.
Won't you turn yellow on me now, Stone? This is my last shot.
Our last shot. So don't do anything crazy.
Announcing the Jeep Cherokee $500 rebate. Make your best deal. Apply it to your down payment or get a check from Jeep Corporation. Come on into your Jeep dealer today.
Supercharged. Soccer. Catch the Detroit Express as they battle the Memphis Rogues Saturday, April 5, 7:30 p.m. at the Silverdome.
Express, yes, Express, yes!
Hey, Mom, right now's the time to get all those great new styles that kids want for spring at Richards Boys and Girls Wear.
Spring?
That's right. No, that's dumb.
I told two friends what super body I get with Fabergé Organic Shampoo with pure wheat germ oil and honey.
And I told two friends what super shine I get with Fabergé Organic Shampoo.
And I told two friends how super fresh my hair smells with Fabergé Organic Shampoo.
For super body, super shine, and super fresh smelling hair, use it every day.
You'll tell two friends, and they'll tell two friends, and so on.
Fabergé Organic Shampoo and Conditioner with pure wheat germ oil and honey.
The time is now. We found a way to make a dream come true. Our yesterday still lives today if we can work with you.
There's a lot worth saving in this country. That's why in our cities, towns, and neighborhoods, the National Trust for Historic Preservation is helping us keep our American heritage alive for ourselves and for our kids.
There's something going on.
Make a dream come true.
The country's growing on.
We can work with you.
We've been building on the best of yesterday. It's the best our nation has. And if we work to make it last, then we're gonna have a better life today.
Preservation builds the nation. Contact the National Trust.
It's 9 o'clock. Do you know what your children are watching?
Tonight, the concluding chapter of Irwin Shaw's The Top of the Hill.
May I come in?
I don't think it's very smart.
So what?
I suppose Dave finds out.
I can do what I want to do.
Where is she, Michael?
Oh, wait a minute. Norma isn't here.
She was, wasn't she? I'll tell you something. If I find out she's in your room, I'll kill you.
You see, if you would find out about us, he'd go on loving me. But you...
It's got to be sensational.
You really want to kill yourself.
Get out of here before I kill you.
You don't have the guts, do you?
It's my dream, Amy.
Well, I don't care about your dream. I'm sick and tired of your dream in these mountains.
Won't you turn yellow on me now, Stone? This is my last shot.
Our last shot. So don't do anything crazy.
Before the dramatic conclusion of Irwin Shaw's The Top of the Hill, a synopsis of the story so far. We've seen that Michael Stone is a man who pushes life to its limits regardless of the cost. For a wife who loves him, Michael's recklessness is hard to understand.
Montreal. Think they'd have one closer than that.
On what?
A terrible Porsche.
No more cars. No more planes. No more crazy chances. Michael, I'm not going to help you kill yourself.
I came to tell you that I'm not going to Europe for you. You interrupted this meeting for that.
No, I interrupted the meeting to tell you that I'm quitting. Look, Bobby, she wanted me to change my life. That's what I'm trying to do.
Montreal.
I don't like placids nearby. When I was a kid, I grew up there. I was a ski instructor.
So, in a search for purpose and in an attempt to piece his life back together, Michael Stone returns to the scene of his youth and to those he left behind.
Well, look who's back in town.
Hello, Norma.
You married?
Yeah, I'm married. We're kind of separated right now.
I'll drink to that.
Michael, turn off the light, please.
Yes. I'm Andreas Hegener. Please come in.
My wife, Mr. Stone, tells me that she's persuaded you to stay on here as a skiing instructor. But skiing's not your profession, is it?
Good. I see you two have met. Come, sit by me.
Finding only temporary answers to the questions he has about the meaning of life, the temptation to challenge death constantly pulls at the center of Michael Stone.
Some kind of spill you took the other day.
Yeah.
How's your partner?
He'll pull through in 6 months.
You could use a new partner, couldn't you?
Yeah, it's a little late for that.
What about me?
You?
Here, then, is Michael Stone, a man seeking a dream who now stands at a crossroad. As we return to our story at the top of the hill.
Okay, in this run, we'll take it easy.
I'll manage to hang on.
Yeah, you touch your brakes, you'll never ride with me again.
Don't worry.
Let's go.
Four.
call him a White House Romeo, a young Errol Flynn. He's the president's son on the rebound from a disastrous divorce. In this week's Star, you'll learn how Chip Carter's conduct enraged the president. Get Chip's amorous exploits in the Star this week. The Star also tells how Kenny Rogers' fight to the top killed three marriages, reveals the overweight champ, and gives you 101 simple money-saving tips like these from Heloise, plus the private lives of the wild and wacky stars of TV's Dallas. Join the 12 million readers in the Star this week.
Ellen, want to lose weight? Control yourself. Cindy, overweight? Control yourself. With the Control Diet Plan. Control contains nothing but a clinically proven weight loss ingredient and not a speck of stimulant. So just one capsule can help you stick to your diet all day long. Ellen?
I've got Control.
Cindy?
Nope. I'm losing weight with Control.
Want to lose weight without stimulants? Control yourself.
Driving a fancy brand new car doesn't make you what you are. Dressing like a fashion plate isn't only why you rate. Eating out where it costs a ton isn't always this much fun.
'Cause you've got what it takes. It shows in what you do. Zoning's the wine for you. You and Zoning. You got what it takes.
Despite all this talk about new tampons, many women have found that Tampax Super Plus gives us super comfort in a Super Plus protection. Now that's a real plus. And it's been proved by women just like you and me in doctor-supervised tests.
Remember, Tampax Super Plus, proven by women in doctor-supervised tests to give super comfort in a Super Plus protection tampon.
Fabulous.
What are you doing? You crazy?
You told me not to hit the brakes.
Yeah, you know the guy we almost hit?
Yeah, well, we didn't.
Well, if we had, they'd still be picking up the pieces, his and ours.
Well?
What?
He wanted to know if I had the nerve.
Yeah.
And?
Okay, you can ride with me. We've got to work on our push-off. There's not much time left before the trial. Well, why not?
We're a team?
We're a team. Let's go. Hey, now that we're a team, you can help me push the sled into the sled shed.
Mr. Hegner, sir.
Thank you.
That was wonderful, Michael.
You're terrific. I don't think you need a ski instructor.
Well, I couldn't have done it if you weren't there right beside me all the way. You make me feel secure, and I like to feel secure.
On skis?
Mm-hmm. On skis and other places, too. You please me, Michael. You please me very much.
You don't do so bad yourself.
You wanted to talk to me about a friend of yours.
Yeah, he's gonna have a little trouble paying his hotel bill.
Oh?
Yeah, unless he gets a job here.
And exactly what kind of job did he have in mind?
Plays the piano.
Oh, yes, that's whom I've heard. He plays very well. But I don't think we need a piano player. You see, our guests kind of amuse themselves. Hey, does this piano player ski?
As a matter of fact, he does. Even better than I do. A couple of years ago at Chamonix, he won the downhill.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what. Considering that he is a friend of yours, I think I could use another ski instructor.
I'll tell him. He'll be grateful.
Yes. Well, I'm not very interested in his gratitude, Michael. You late again, Rita?
Look, it's my fault she's late. One of my bindings came loose and we had to stop.
Well, that is none of my concern, is it now? Now what are you waiting for?
Nothing.
Don't you think you were a little rough on her? She was only a few minutes late.
Yes, I suppose you're right. I'll talk to her later, even apologize if you think that's what I should do.
What I think has nothing to do with it.
On the contrary, what do you think has everything to do with it, Michael?
Want to take another run from the top of the hill?
No, I don't think so. I better go down and spend a little time with Andreas. And I'll see you later tonight, all right?
Okay, I'll be in the bar.
Wait for me in your room.
Ava, I can't do that now. Not with your husband here.
Oh, but that doesn't change anything.
It does for me.
Listen to me, Michael. I need you. Don't you understand that? I need you.
Ava, you only hired me to teach skiing. How are you feeling today?
Just fine. My wife tells me that she seldom enjoyed skiing as much as she does with you.
We had a good run.
A good run. One remembers the good runs. Once at Zermatt, under the Matterhorn, it was a day very much like this. Clear, perfect snow. No wind. A guide took me up the teleférique to Théodule Pass. There, from the top of that mountain, you can ski from Switzerland all the way down to Italy, to Cervinia.
And you did this?
Oh, yes. Great open slopes above the timberline where you can ski and ski forever. As if you're sailing above the world below. Unattached to its problems and free from all care. A marvelous feeling, Mr. Stone.
I can imagine.
Well, perfect day, and I'm keeping you from the mountain.
There's plenty of time, don't worry.
No, there's never enough. When I was still skiing, I always resented the sun going down. There was always one more run I wanted to make. There still is.
Well, why don't you do it?
Ski?
Yeah, sure.
The doctors have warned me about the exertion. You see how slowly I walk.
Well, you can ski slowly.
You're tempting me, Mr. Stone. It's just possible. A little mild skiing might be therapeutic. I'd need someone to go with me.
I'd be happy to go.
Yes. I'd like to go up on the mountain with you.
Magic powers.
I was beginning to think you'd never notice. What did I do now?
Well,
Mrs. Hegener came and apologized to me. And to Rita, she said something about you being upset over the way she behaved.
Oh, yeah, and since you're in such an exalted position with the management, did you talk to them about me?
Yeah, I mentioned it to her.
And?
You've got a job.
All right.
Great.
See, I told you you could do it.
As a ski instructor.
As a what?
A ski instructor.
A ski instructor? I've never been on a pair of skis in my life. What are you talking about, Michael?
Bobby, it's the only job I could get you.
I can't ski. I mean, I don't know any... what am I going to do?
Well, the first thing you're going to do is you're going over to the pro shop, and you're going to pick up one of these emblems and get your instructor schedule from Dave Colley.
I don't think you heard me at all. I cannot ski. Will you stop laughing? This is serious.
I can't help it. I think it's funny.
Michael, you did it to me again.
No, I didn't. See, after you go and pick up the emblem, then what you're going to do is you're going to trip on the stairs and sprain your ankle.
Trip on the stairs and sprain my ankle. Oh, I trip on the stairs and sprain my ankle.
Right.
Then I can't ski. I get paid for that?
Right.
Michael, that's brilliant. That's brilliant. Thanks, partner. Then what do I do?
What you always do. Play the piano.
Norma? Honey?
Don't start nagging. It's the first drink I've had all day.
You said you were gonna stop.
One drink isn't gonna hurt me. What do you expect me to do? Stuck in here all day, every day.
Well, there's a lot you could do.
Like what? Watch you get some fat old lady down the hill? No, thanks.
No, I mean like in Placid.
You mean get a job, don't you?
We could use the money, couldn't we?
And we could keep Norma busy. That's the real reason, isn't it?
Your father'd give you a job. He offered.
I don't want to work for my father. It's bad enough, the way he looks at me sometimes. Norma, you're breaking my heart.
Well, if you weren't so selfish, maybe you'd realize that you are.
Then let him mind his own damn business.
Herb's been good to us.
Good old Herb. Still paying the bills when good old Dave can't.
Good old Dave doesn't spend all the money, Norma.
Come on, baby.
Do we always have to argue? Want to hear some good news?
Mm-hmm. Do you?
Mm. About my new bobsled partner? You ready for it? It's Michael Stone.
Whoopee.
It's kind of funny, isn't it? I mean, me and Michael riding together.
Yeah, what's funny about it?
Well, I think it's kind of funny. You know, after all these years, you know what I mean.
Be a lot funnier if it was me and Michael after all these years.
Oh, you gotta do it, don't you? Always gotta do it. Always gotta throw it up in my face about you and Michael. Me and Michael this. That's all I've heard for years. Everything we did, you and I, you and Michael, always did it first.
And better.
You swore you never went to bed with him.
Too bad.
What is that supposed to mean?
I'm getting another drink.
No. No, you're not.
come in?
I don't think it's very smart.
So what?
I suppose Dave finds out.
I can do what I want to do. I don't need Dave Cully's permission.
Normally, you're Dave's wife.
Lucky me. He told me how you're his new bobsled partner. Congratulations.
You're not going to try to mess that up, are you?
Maybe I ought to. You weren't very nice to me, Michael. Leaving the way you did, never calling, never writing, as if I never existed.
You just didn't care. You see, I loved you, Michael. Then and all those years. I loved you when I married Dave. I even used to pretend it was you with me in bed. I loved you right up until the moment that I saw you again. You know what that did? That took my little dream away, my little game. And that was all I had.
Norman, that doesn't make any sense.
It does to me. I wasted my life because of... You never loved me. Not for a moment. I know we never said it, but I thought sometimes. I wasted my life because of you.
Is that the way you dress when you receive your guests?
Well, well, well. I wasn't expecting any guests.
Except me and Dave Cully's wife.
You know her?
Obviously not half as well as you do. What did she want?
She wanted to tell me something.
Must have been very important, because he didn't even bother to dress. Andrea said you're going to take him skiing.
He wants to go?
Against medical advice.
Listen, your husband doesn't strike me as the sort of person who wants to sit around in a chair all day with a blanket over his shoulders.
Oh, you're right. Not Andreas. But I still think to ski would be very dangerous for him.
Well, then why don't you tell him?
Oh, I have.
And?
And he still insists on going with you.
Well, in that case, I guess he goes.
What would happen if I would forbid you to take him?
I doubt if it would do any good.
That's what I thought. You're a difficult man, Michael. And I like difficult men. A lot.
Ever I saw your face, I thought the sun rose in your eyes, and the moon and the stars were the gift to the dark and the end of time, my love, to the dark and the end of time, my love.
Well?
Not bad for a ski instructor.
Thanks.
Hey, Dave, how you doing?
Where is she, Michael? Oh, wait a minute. Norma isn't here. She was, wasn't she? Damn it, Stone. You better not lie to me. She came to see you.
She came to see me. She told me what a rotten guy I was, and she left.
And what else happened?
Nothing. I mean, she was a little upset.
Yeah, yeah, because of you. I'll tell you something. If I find out she's in your room...
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. She's not here. You want to go look in my room? You go right ahead.
I'm warning you, Stone. I'm warning you. If I find out anything... I'll kill you.
I don't know how you do it. You've only been here a few days and you're up to here.
It's a gift.
I want to tell you something, my friend. That's one angry man. Be careful.
Gloria Vanderbilt introduces beautiful playwear you wear everywhere. It's playwear that's travel wear, playwear that's disco wear, playwear that's party wear from Gloria Vanderbilt. And then there's playwear that's pizza wear, playwear that's biking wear, playwear that's striking wear. It's beautiful playwear you wear everywhere from Gloria Vanderbilt by Merjani.
At Hudson.
Tell you the truth, last time around, I didn't even vote. Now, this time, look, the Democrats have been in charge of Congress for 25 years now, right? Well, what's my family got to show for it? I work hard, my wife works hard. We still can't make it. We want to buy a home of our own. Who can afford it? We can't even go away on vacation this year. Well, this time, I am going to vote. And you better believe it won't be for the Democrats.
Vote Republican for a change.
Saturday at 4 p.m., experience the adventure of the open road. Tour the famed California Gold Rush country by motorcycle. And let E.G. Marshall give you a glimpse of this fascinating region of our country and a bygone era. See the road and the wind. Saturday at 4 p.m., right here on TV2.
Wendy's chili's got more meat than my mama's chili.
Wendy's chili has more meat than my daddy's chili.
Wendy's chili has more meat than my mother's chili.
At Wendy's, we put more meat in our chili than most homemade recipes.
At Wendy's, we put more meat in our chili than most people put in their hamburgers.
Wendy's chili, it's got more meat than mama's chili.
How do you feel?
Oh, to be on skis again, I never thought it could happen. I must confess that I was beginning to think of myself as an invalid. And that's a sure way of becoming one.
A good run.
One worth remembering?
Oh, yes, Mr. Stone. Definitely worth remembering. To make it all the harder to go back into the hospital.
So why do you have to?
The doctors and my wife insist it's for the best. I'm not convinced that they're right, but...
You'll go.
My wife, as you may have noticed, is a very strong-willed woman. Once she sets her mind to something, God help you. But to be fair, I must like that. That's what I chose. For me, Ava's the perfect woman, with only one slight flaw.
What's that?
She doesn't like it here. At least not as much as I want her to.
She seems to enjoy the skiing.
Yes, lately more than ever. I suppose I have you to thank for that as well. If you have no plans for this evening, I'd enjoy it very much if you'd come for dinner. And I'm sure Eva would be pleased.
Okay.
If you were coming.
Hey, we had a date to practice, didn't we?
Yeah, let's get it out. Hey, look, about last night, I was acting like a real jerk.
Well, did you find it?
Yeah, I found her down the highway in some bar. We had a hell of a scene, but I finally got her home. Huh. Marriage can be tough sometimes.
Tell me about it.
You too?
Yeah.
You know, Mike, in spite of it all, I love her. I guess I'd have to put up with all that.
Yeah.
Well, let's get ourselves down this hill.
It is really cold out there.
Yeah, well, if you're dumb enough to go outside, it is. I mean, all that snow. My blood's too thin. Of all the places to pick, I mean, Puerto Vallarta, Saint-Tropez, why don't you pick this one? However, I'm very glad you did.
Listen, I got something for you.
Oh. It's a coincidence. I got something for you, too.
Did you know she was there?
Not till I saw that. Maria tells me Buffalo's not that far away. Gonna call her?
What for?
Say hello. You know, tell her we're neighbors.
She said she wanted to have time to think. She knows where I am. She can call me.
Michael, why are you being so stubborn? I mean, she might not even know you're here.
She knows I'm here. That is, unless you forgot to give Barney Bloom the telephone number.
Well, I gave him the number. Maybe he's doing you a favor.
Speaking of favors, you better open that.
What is this, Henry?
It's your instructor's schedule.
You mean you were serious? What are we gonna do now?
That's right.
I don't have any better ideas.
When?
Well, let's see, your first class starts at 9 o'clock in the morning, so, any time between now and then.
Okay, I'll do it.
Well, if you're gonna do it, you better do it now, before you change your mind.
Now?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, now.
Yeah, right, I'll just do it now. If you'll excuse me, I have to go upstairs, kids. Hey, would you mind giving me a kiss for good luck before I...
Why not?
It is dangerous.
I know.
So I just go up and then just sort of...
Yeah.
I got it.
Listen, I tell you what. Take him out to the car, we bandage him up, and then we just tell everybody that we've been to the hospital. Okay?
Antoine, told me you were crazy.
Down the steps.
Cheers, my friend.
I hate you for this.
Oh.
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 How terrible.
Oh. 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 no.
Oh, no, yes.
Oh, no.
Oh,
oh no.
Hey, you were terrific.
Oh.
Don't overact.
Overacting? Hell, I really broke my ankle. Michael, I'm gonna kill you. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Again, for a brilliant idea, you know what I mean? Actually, I didn't have to travel this far to get all busted up. I could have stayed home. They would have been glad to bust my arm. Hey, could you tell him to put a piano in my room, please?
Tell him to sew up his mouth.
Forecast is correct. The skiing could continue into April. A long season and a good one. But like all good things, it will come to an end. Then what will you do?
I don't know. The idea of going back to an air-conditioned office with a desk full of paperwork doesn't exactly knock me out.
In that case, why don't you stay on?
What would I do?
The summers are quite pleasant. The lodge will be open, business as usual.
It's not a business I know anything about.
I'm sure you could learn rather quickly, Mr. Stone. Excuse me. Yes, I'm all right, thanks. I'll be back in a minute. Excuse me.
He doesn't seem well. Are you sure he's all right?
Yes, it is not a severe attack. I know the symptoms, believe me. Sit down, Michael. Andrea seems quite taken with you, and he doesn't take to people that easily.
We get along.
Oh, no, no, it's more than that. I think he sees in you the son he never had. That is rather amusing, wouldn't you say?
Depends on your sense of humor.
Now, don't tell me you have a guilty conscience, Michael.
Maybe.
However, as much as he likes you, he loves me more. Don't ever forget that. You see, if he would find out about us, he'd go on loving me. But you...
You make it sound like a warning.
Well, I've been saving this cognac for a special occasion.
Are you all right?
Yes, thank you.
Don't you think this is overdoing it a little bit?
Yes, and it feels quite wonderful. In fact, I'm going to indulge myself all the way.
I suppose there's nothing I could say that would stop you, is there?
Not tonight. Tonight I feel like celebrating. Will you join me, Mr. Stone?
Only in the cognac.
Today I skied. Tonight, I feel better than I've felt in years.
In that case, here's to skiing.
To skiing. Remember that run I told you about from Switzerland to Italy?
Who could forget it?
Yes, you're right. Well, the ski run here could never compare to it. But if we went all the way to the top of the mountain and built a run, starting on the other side, then curved it around,
could be fantastic. That would be a run that would go for miles. But how would you get the skiers to the top?
We'd have to build a funicular. From the top of the lift to the top of the mountain.
It could cost a lot of money.
All in all, more than a million. But we'd have the best and the longest run in the United States. The whole world, actually. Second only to one. I have the plans in my office.
You never told me about that, Andreas.
Well, that's because until now, it's only been a dream. But after the Olympics, it could become a reality. And I'd need someone to supervise the entire operation.
Well, now you're satisfied?
Unfortunately, I'm afraid you were right again.
Come on, Andreas. I want you upstairs to lie down and rest.
You'll forgive me, Mr. Stone?
Oh, don't worry about my... It seems awful. Come on.
I was afraid he'd be asleep.
Wide awake. How's Antoine?
Complaining. They're keeping him in the hospital overnight. It was a very neat fracture. You know, he's not very pleased with either one of us.
Well, you can hardly blame me. Listen, would you like to have a drink?
No, the bar's empty. I looked. It's too quiet.
Why don't you come on inside?
Well, I really shouldn't keep you up.
You're not? I couldn't sleep.
Neither can I. I guess it's just one of those nights.
I guess it is.
I think of Canada. I think of flying in for the greatest fishing in the world and discovering the best beer I ever tasted, Labatt's.
Labatt's, the good taste of Canada beer.
The other day, I rediscovered Labatt's right here in our town. It's imported now. And that's what I call good news.
When you think of Canada,
think of Labatt's.
Smart shoppers save at Kroger, more than a million strong.
Each week, Kroger has a variety of different kinds and cuts of meat, cost-cutter priced in the Kroger meat case. Here are just two of many you'll find on sale this week.
Enjoy the fresh, juicy taste and easy preparation of fresh turkey for Easter. And this week, a Kroger fresh-dressed turkey with pop-up timer is just 69 cents a pound.
Come cut your costs at Kroger. A million Michigan shoppers can't be wrong.
I saw first Mac.
Mac?
It's hard to look like a woman in a raincoat designed for a man. It's easy in a coat by Fleet Street.
Fleet Street, you're the woman at Fleet Street. Fleet Street, Fleet Street, you're the woman at Fleet Street. Fleet Street.
May I show you a cab?
Okay.
Some folks know about calico cats, and some folks know about trees, and some folks know about keeping cool and how to fan the breeze. But Grandma knows about cookies, she knows that subject well, and Grandma's sold on Archway, and she's a tough cookie to sell.
At Archway Cookies, we not only make them the way your grandmother used to, we sell them to her.
Yes, Grandma's sold on Archway, and she's a tough cookie to sell.
How do you feel?
Well, I'm not very proud of myself. Listen, Michael, it wasn't your fault. I came to you, not the other way around. But, I just want you to know that that's not something I do very often.
I know.
Thanks. Thanks for making it so easy. Catch you later.
Good morning, Michael.
How's your husband?
He's resting now. He had a rather bad night, but he's feeling much better this morning. Fever is down a little, so that's good.
Sure it's all right to leave him alone?
As a matter of fact, it was he who insisted that I meet you. But I don't feel much like seeing today. I've got something else planned for us. Come on, I'll show you.
Come with me.
You know, you handle that machine pretty well.
Just another toy. Look down there.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Yes, it is beautiful and dull. And the idea of spending another season here is just about driving me out of my mind.
Could be very busy here this summer.
That run won't happen, Michael.
Why not?
Mirror Mountain has just about killed Andreas the way it is. To start building again would be more than he could handle. Listen, if he offers you a job, don't take it. Don't encourage his fantasy, please.
It could be a spectacular run.
Well, since Andreas has managed to involve you in this foolishness already, I'll tell you what's going to happen. Right after the Olympics, we are going to sell Mirror Mountain. There are several interested parties I've talked to, and everything seems to be set.
Whose decision is that?
Andreas will do what I tell him to. You should know that by now, Michael. Come on, let's go on back down. We shouldn't leave poor Andreas alone for too long. Should we now?
Brilliant ideas. Do me a big favor, will you? Leave me out.
Listen, what are you doing out here? You're supposed to be inside near the fire with your feet propped up telling lies.
Yeah, I was just watching Maria come down the steps. You know, she's really something, Michael. I'm taken by her. I'm really taken by her.
Congratulations.
You know, last night in that hospital, in that little room, I had these awful thoughts.
Well, that's not like you.
You know what I was thinking about, Michael? I was thinking about you. I was saying, you know, Michael's one of those kind of guys that everything happens to. Me, nothing happens to. I mean, you got a beautiful wife. I know you got your problems, but women like you, Michael. I mean, you can just pick and choose whoever you want.
Are you telling me not to choose Maria?
Well, I wasn't going to put it so bluntly, but now that you said it, yeah. Don't choose Maria, Michael.
Okay, my friend, as of now, you've got a clear field.
You know, all I gotta worry about is those thoughts, you know, those awful thoughts.
Maybe you had a bad dream, a bad night. Who knows?
Really? Well, in that case, I'm gonna go into the lodge and I'm gonna prop up my foot and I'm gonna astound everyone by telling them about my skiing adventures in the... Hey, where do you ski in France?
Val d'Isère, Chamonix.
Chamonix. They still talk about me there. The French Boulette, the Alpine Arrow, the Dolomite Daredevil. What's the name of that place?
Chamonix.
Mwah. Au revoir, my friend.
Au revoir.
Thank you.
Rita's your biggest fan.
I know, but she always stands so far away.
Well, then call her over.
Hey, Rita. Rita, come here a minute. How you doing?
All right.
You like this song?
Yes.
Okay, I'll play one of my two-hour introductions, and then you come in.
He's pretty smooth the way he encourages Rita, huh?
He's smooth about you, too.
What do you mean?
He asked about us. I told him he had nothing to worry about.
He doesn't. I want to keep it that way, okay?
I know.
Thanks.
You are so beautiful. Beautiful. To me, can't you see? You're everything I hope for. You're everything I need. You are so beautiful to me.
Ah, Michael, I was on the way to your room when I realized you'd probably be in the bar with your friends. Andrea's fever's up again. I talked to the doctor. They want him back in the hospital by tomorrow.
Does he know that?
About the hospital, yes, and he's complaining as usual. He would like you to drive him there. You know, the more he talks about this insane plan of his, the worse he gets.
Plan happens to make a lot of sense.
But not for him, Michael, not for him. It's killing him. I mean, just thinking about it is more excitement than he can stand. You. Coming from your kind of background, I mean, he'd listen to you. You could make him understand. Please.
Okay, I'll try.
Thank you. Then you'll be there at 8 o'clock?
I'll be there at 8.
You can use the large station wagon. I'd better get back to him now. It's going to be a long night.
Greenest lawn in the neighborhood with Green Power, the long-lasting fertilizer for greener, thicker lawns. And for real savings, get A-Stone Latex flat wall paint, covers in one coat, and it's guaranteed 5 waves. And you can solve the problem of where to put things with KV unfinished shelving. On sale now.
If you're thinking about buying central air conditioning this year, think twice. An air conditioner can do only one job. But the energy-efficient electric heat pump does too. Added to your present forced air furnace, it cools your home in summer and helps heat it in winter to save oil or natural gas and cut your fuel bills.
So, think twice. The heat pump cools your home and heats it too with plenty of available energy from Detroit Edison.
Ask Detroit Edison how energy plus the heat pump can help keep the power in your hands.
I tipped him $200.
Michael, this place is weird.
Okay, okay. We can always leave.
We've got our Citicorp traveler's checks.
The psychological advantage of Citicorp. Traveler's checks accepted worldwide. We even have our own banks in 64 countries.
Oh. Come here. Look, right across the street, a Citibank.
Can we eat dinner there?
I'll call.
Travel the world with us. Citicorp traveler's checks.
From the TV2 Eyewitness Newsroom, this is Newsbreak. The state Senate has approved a measure allowing a study to proceed on a Detroit subway plan, but it took a second vote to get it through. The prime rate has hit another record today, climbing to the 20% mark. Some analysts say it'll start to come down now, but others say it may continue to go up. White House officials say President Carter is trying to sort out the latest signals from Iran concerning our American hostages there. Those are some of the stories we'll have for you in Eyewitness News at 11.
Way down the hill. Fantastic.
That is the craziest thing anybody can do. I mean, to get up
there.
That's
terrific. It's gotta be great. It's gotta be fun.
Fun? Michael, don't even think about it.
You're too late anyway. Do you know how old those jumpers are when they start? Like 8, 9, 10 years old. I mean, that's not something you just pick up casually along the way.
It's gotta be some feeling, though. You're up there at the top. You're looking down just before you go. It's got to be sensational.
You know what? I'm convinced. You really want to kill yourself.
I've got to talk to you.
Is it Andreas?
Come with me.
Is he all right?
Yes, yes, Andreas is just fine. Please, Michael, now.
I'll be right back.
No, he won't. Excuse me.
Wait a minute. What do you want?
Just come with me, okay? Look, you sit in there with all your friends and leave me all alone. I just don't like that, all right?
Well, why don't you join us? Antoine plays very well.
I don't give a damn how Antoine plays. I want to be with you. Please come with me.
We've been through this all before. There's no point in going through it again.
Do you know what it's been like living with Andreas for all these years? I need you, Michael. Look, I'll do anything for you. Anything at all.
Listen to me. I want you to go home.
Yeah. And you'll come with me, huh?
No.
You. Today, huh? You know what? I want to try it from the top of the hill, huh?
Have you ever done it before?
No, not all the way, but today I just know I can do it. Huh? Let's go. Come on.
Carried away, aren't you?
I know what I'm doing.
Well, you're cutting it a little thin. Why don't you take it easy, okay?
I'll ski the way I want to.
Listen, you take a bad fall going through those woods at that speed, you won't be on skis again for a long time. Now, slow down, you understand me?
What's the matter, Michael? You're afraid?
Maybe you better get another instructor.
Uh-huh. In everything, it seems.
Ava! Ava!
Hi. Were you worried?
Are you hurt?
Good. You were worried.
Of course I was worried.
Come and kiss me, huh? Come kiss me.
Come on, get up. Come on.
Would you fix my bindings? Give me my poles? Thank you.
Hello, Elizabeth.
Hello, Michael.
You just happened to be in the neighborhood and thought you'd drop in. What the hell are you looking at? You called her, didn't you?
Why don't you kids sit down? You probably got a lot to talk about.
Come on, sweetheart. I guess I should have been the one to telephone you, huh?
But you didn't.
I thought about it.
Every second?
Come on.
Nothing's changed, has it?
I still love you.
But you're still doing the same things. Only this time, instead of cars, it's bobsleds.
You've got a big mouth. Who said it was a secret?
I thought of a lot of things to say on my way up here. I've had all these conversations with you over and over again in my mind.
And?
I want to be with you, Michael.
With you.
Not the way it was before. Not the way you were before.
Elizabeth, listen. Together, we can work this out.
Michael, you have to work it out, not me. If you really want our marriage, it's up to you.
How?
You know how.
You mean the bobsled trials? I can't walk out on that.
You mean you don't want to?
What the hell am I supposed to do? Dave Cully's my partner. Am I going to go up there and tell him my wife says I can't play?
you. How long can you stay?
I have to be back in Buffalo by Wednesday night.
And after that?
I don't know. I told Barney to hold off on my bookings until I talked to him.
Michael. Hi, I was going to join you for a little while.
This is my wife, Elizabeth. Oh, I'm sorry, this is Eva Hagen.
Hello. How do you do?
She and her husband own the lodge here.
Oh. You didn't tell me your wife was coming, Michael.
Well, it was kind of a surprise.
Yes, I bet it was. Well, you two must have so much to talk about, so I'll see you later. Oh, so very nice to have met you, Mrs. Stone.
Didn't leave much room for speculation, did it?
I guess not.
Nice of her to let me know.
Well, Elizabeth...
It's all right. We're separated. That means you can do what you want to do.
What I want to do is spend the night with you.
And I can do what I want to do. I don't want to sleep with you, Michael. I've been sleeping alone since I left you.
I didn't ask.
Not that I haven't had opportunities. That was my choice. It may not be my choice much longer.
What the hell is that supposed to mean? I mean, you trying to make me angry?
I'm sorry. Either we're married or we're not.
Stay with me tonight. Please.
Until recently, halogen headlights were reserved for jets. Now your car can have Power Plus halogen headlights, only from GE. Compared to conventional high beams, they're whiter, brighter, in situations like these.
Take a look and you'll see how bright lights can be. Power Plus headlights can light up your way.
Get a far sight better light.
Wow.
Power Plus halogen headlights.
GE, we bring good things to life.
Mr. Merritt, what kind of flea collar should I use on Mrs. Courtney's poodle?
Let me tell you about flea and tick collars, son. Some kill fleas and ticks like a powder, others like a spray. Only one works both ways. Sentry 5 from Sargent's works like a powder and a spray.
What kind of collar are you putting on my Sammy?
Let me tell you about flea and tick collars, ma'am.
For your dog or cat, get the only collar that works like a powder and a spray. The Sargent's Sentry 5 collar.
If the bigger burger's on your mind,
take me to the biggest burger you can find.
All right. A burger of a different kind.
And it even has bacon on it.
Do you like a burger chef?
We call it Top Chef.
Top Chef and Burger Chef.
Two Top Chefs. Real cheese and crispy bacon on a third pound of pure beef.
Third is bigger than a quarter, right?
Our Top Chef burger. Terrific with hot fries and a Coke.
Get more with your meal. Come feel like a burger chef.
You feel full.
I feel full.
I will be singing in the sunshine. Anyway, Crystal Lee Sutton, the real woman upon whom the movie Norma Rae was based, will explain her battles with management.
We'll get insight into the beliefs of the Orthodox Catholic and find out how they feel about life in the 80s.
And you and guest host Henry Baskin set up housekeeping, don't you, Kathy?
Well, in a way, but you'll have to see for yourself tomorrow at 8 on Good Morning Detroit.
Next up, the McVeigh team. McVeigh team next. The McVeigh team to the line.
Time for Michaels. 1:06:08. Clear the track.
Yeah.
Yep.
That'll be the time to beat.
Well, let's beat it.
The track is clear.
One more in there next. Don't worry, it'll be all right.
I don't think I should have come.
Michael's not driving, Dave Cully is.
Oh, well, at least that's one small favor to be thankful for.
As long as they stay away from the lip.
What does that mean?
Well, in the big curve up there, the higher they go, the faster they come down. But there's a cement lip on top. If the sled hits that, well, that's when it gets dangerous.
Watch this one.
The McVay run has been disqualified.
Oh, they're okay.
See, it's not so bad.
Next up, the Cully sled.
Clear the track.
Cully sled to the
line.
Let's
win this one, okay? Ready.
The track is clear.
Too close. Too close.
Let's get out of here. I can't stand this.
Come on, let's go.
Did you enjoy it?
No, I didn't.
You know how close you came to getting ill.
I think we better go. Bye.
Yeah, right.
There's just no stopping you, is there? Michael, last night I couldn't sleep. I decided I was being a fool. I had myself convinced that it was me, that I just didn't understand, that what I was asking you was too much. No, Michael, I'm not wrong. You just proved it.
Oh, by winning?
You know what I mean. I want a divorce, Michael.
Andreas called from the hospital. He wants you to pick him up.
Right now? Is he all right?
He's waiting for you. Here.
Thank you.
Thank you. So when the doctors told me they'd finished all the tests, there's no reason to spend another night in this dismal place. I knew you'd come when you could, so I just waited. Ava said you were at the bobsled trials.
Yep. Had the best time of the day.
Really?
Yeah.
You should be out celebrating instead of making this dull journey.
Afraid there's not much to celebrate about.
Going to celebrate, then what are you going to do?
Rest up for the finals tomorrow.
Well, don't try too hard to win.
That's what it's all about, isn't it? Winning?
No. Living is what it's all about. Winning is a luxury you can't always afford. Sometimes the price of victory is too high. The offer I made you. Take it, Michael. Take the chance I'm giving you, and you take it for both of us.
What do you mean?
I don't have much time left. The doctors can't be specific, but this is the last remission. But please don't say anything to Ava. There's no point in her having to live with such an unpleasant prospect. When that moment comes, that'll be time enough for her to know. I'm sorry. Because I think you and I would have been good friends.
We are good friends.
It pleases me to hear you say that. Give me your answer soon, Michael. I won't ask you again.
Dear.
Dear.
You look wonderful, dear.
Yes, for once, I think the doctors knew what they were doing.
Thank you so much, Michael, for bringing him home.
Anytime.
Oh, you shouldn't be standing out here in the cold, dear. It's not good for you.
It'll be a beautiful day tomorrow. I think I'd like to ski in the morning.
I'll meet you here.
Andreas, come on, dear.
Yes.
Thank you again.
I'm coming.
Maybe it just needs a little more time. Maybe after tomorrow we'll...
After tomorrow. Suppose they win. He'll just want to do it again. It doesn't make sense to wait, Bobby.
But you and Michael love each other. You belong together. I can't see it any other way.
I know. But I can't stay with him.
Yeah. Boy, I don't feel like playing the piano tonight.
But you will.
Yeah, I will. I will.
Out.
Well, tomorrow's a big day. You coming?
Come on, honey. Why don't you...
Don't.
Why not?
You want something to eat?
Oh, I'd like to know if you're going to come to the bobsled trial.
I'll make you a sandwich.
I don't want a sandwich.
Let go of me.
What's the matter?
Everything.
Norma, look, I know I haven't, you know, given you much of a life, I mean, the way you really want it. And God knows that you deserve better, right? But let me just tell you this. I always did the very best that I could, and you know that. I mean, you're the prettiest girl I ever saw. I mean, the moment you were 16 years old, I never wanted anything so bad in my life.
Well, you got it, didn't you?
Yeah. The first time, I was so happy I just thought I'd explode. I don't know, maybe we could never be that happy again, could we?
I was never happy.
Sure you were. When we were first in love, you were happy.
No, I never loved you.
Sure you did.
Never. Not for a moment.
You're lying.
When you touched me, I hated it. Being with you, it made me sick. Sometimes I'd pretend, and pretending just made it worse. No matter what I did, no matter what I said, you just cringed like a whipped dog. Is that what you call love?
I gave you everything. I did all I could.
Gave me what? This empty house in this stinking town? Pawing me at night?
What did you say? What did you say? Say it!
Pawing me!
You better get out of here. You better get out of here before I kill you.
You don't have the guts, do you? Yeah.
Get out.
You're damn right. I'm getting out before you bore me to death.
Announcing the Jeep Cherokee $500 rebate. Make your best deal. Apply it to your down payment or get a check from Jeep Corporation. Come on into your Jeep dealer today.
I want you to taste both of these colas.
In recent side-by-side blind taste tests, nationwide, more people prefer Pepsi over Coca-Cola. Here's Joyce Jorgensen taking the same kind of test.
Which do you prefer? Tell me what you chose.
Pepsi Cola.
Do you think this is a fair test?
Oh, very definitely. Me doing it proved it even more. I think I'm going to buy a Pepsi Cola. May I finish?
Sure.
That was good.
Let your taste decide. Take the Pepsi challenge.
Hello, I am Charo. These people are so excited about their Mako paint job. Let them tell you why.
I'd recommend Mako to anybody that wants to go out and buy a brand new car with today's prices to get their car painted. They'll be just as happy. They not only painted it, they did a lot of extras as far as shining up the chrome, cleaning the inside, which we didn't expect. The windows even got washed. Fantastic. We're very happy.
Can't wait to drive it.
No motion picture has received more Academy Award nominations than All That Jazz. Best art direction, cinematography, costume design, film editing, original screenplay, score adaptation. Best Director, Best Actor, Roy Scheider, and Best Picture of the Year. All that acclaim for All That Jazz. Rated R.
Now showing at a theater near you.
Book that hit America like a runaway locomotive from the Consumer Information Center of the U.S. government. More than 200 fact-filled federal publications listed inside, and it's free. Write to New Catalog, Pueblo, Colorado, 81009. Don't wait for the movie.
Good morning, Michael.
Good morning. Andreas is expecting me to take him skiing.
Yes, but you see, we both forgot about the bobsled trial, so it won't be possible. But Andreas says he would like you to take him skiing tomorrow. And he also says he really wishes that you went today.
We intend to.
Good. See you tomorrow then, all right?
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Ready, Michael?
Michael can't take you today, darling. He's preparing for the bobsled trials.
Well, we could have gone for an hour.
Well, since you were looking forward to it so much, I'll take you.
Are you sure?
Yes, we haven't skied together for a long time. It could be fun. And I do want to see that run you keep talking about.
Yes, I suppose we could get there. You'll see how beautiful it is.
I'd very much like to. I'll get changed and we'll go after lunch. Oh, Andreas, I'm looking forward to it very much.
How you doing? Hey, do you hear the news? We're in second slot.
Yeah, so?
You okay? What's the matter with you?
Matter, Michael, I'm going to tell you something. We're going to win today. I don't care if there's any paint left in the side of that bobsled, but we're going to win!
Well, look, my friend, we almost went over the top the last time.
Like hell we did. We can save two, maybe 2.5 seconds. Believe me! I'm going to win it!
Well... you can help me?
Yeah. I'm gonna help.
It's finalist day here on Mount Van Hogenberg's Olympic bobsled run this noontime. And you can bet that all the teams are geared up and ready to go. The perfect run with them so far and a perfect start for today's entry.
Time for Jacobson. 1:06:03.
They beat our time. They beat our time.
I know. We'll get it back, eh? Clear the track. The track is clear.
Okay, we're gonna do it, Michael. We're really gonna do it.
Ready?
Say.
Yeah.
It isn't worth it.
What are you talking about? It's not worth it.
Getting killed.
Killed? Killed? Damn it, Michael. This is it for me. Now get in position.
Listen, I've been there. I know where you're headed.
Don't you turn yellow on me now, Stone. This is my last shot.
Our last shot. So don't do anything crazy.
Cully sled to the line. Cully sled to the line.
Are you all right?
Are you all right? The McCulley and Stone sled with both driver and brakeman safe, apparently, has been disqualified.
Why, Michael, why?
I had to.
Man, you didn't have to hit the brake. We were gonna win.
You were out of control. You were gonna kill us.
No, man, I can see it. I mean, we had it all.
You were gonna kill us. We had nothing. We were two guys throwing our lives away.
You cheated me!
I didn't cheat you! I saved your damn life!
Damn you, Michael. Damn you to hell!
This may be a little too difficult.
Oh, come on now, dear. We've come this far, and I want to see this wonderful place of yours.
I need to rest, Ava.
It's just another mountain. Just another damn mountain. I never understood what you saw in them. But that didn't matter, did it, Andreas? It never mattered what I thought. You were the one with the money, so we always did what you wanted to, didn't we?
What are you talking about?
This plan of yours, this new run, you wanted that too. Well, I don't want it.
It's my dream.
Your dream? Well, I don't care about your dream. I'm sick and tired of your dream in these mountains. I want to get rid of this place, sell it, and finally have a chance to enjoy my life. Do you know how much I've hated it up here all this time?
You never told me.
I have told you and told you and told you, but you just never listened. Well, you better listen now, Andreas. There won't be any new run.
I've started all the arrangements.
Yes, I know, with Michael. But you won't do it.
I'm going back down now.
You won't do it because I won't let you do it. I won't let you make me a prisoner here. Do you understand that? Andreas!
Pick up a pack of pickled peppers in Pittsburgh
and unpack it tomorrow in Portland,
or 2 tons of toothpicks in Tucson
and take them to Tuscaloosa?
Who can pick up red sails in the Canadian sunset and deliver them before the moon comes over Miami, or take blueprints from Brownsville all the way to Green Bay?
The answer to any shipping riddle is Emery. We've flown more packages to more places overnight than anyone else.
Or machine pawns from Buffalo
to where the deer and the antelope play.
Emery, from here to there overnight.
Overweight women should do themselves a favor and call.
Weight loss clinic should get some kind of an award.
People are raving about weight loss clinic.
The results.
We have a proven program with results that could amaze you. Call us.
I haven't waited so long.
It's the first program that's worked for me.
Weight loss clinic.
The nurses really care.
Weight loss clinic.
My weight is where it should be.
Weight loss clinic, because it works.
Call this number or check information for the clinic nearest you.
Fabulous.
Cuddle up to stay for softness, loving mine. Cuddle up to stay for freshness, feel so fine. I like to make your stay puff cozy.
concentrated fabric softener.
If there's one thing you can depend on, it's that your favorite glasses will break one way or another. Which means one way or another, you wind up with a collection of unfavorite glasses. Now you can replace your glass menagerie, because now you can get beautiful French lead crystal. At Bank of the Commonwealth, with every deposit of $50 or more in any savings account. So come to the Bank of the Commonwealth today and add a touch of glass.
Michael, we've been trying to find you. The Hegners are missing.
I was afraid you wouldn't wait.
They went skiing this afternoon. They haven't come back yet.
Wait a minute. What are you saying?
I'm saying they're lost. They went up skiing this afternoon. They haven't come back yet. There's a search party up there for them now.
Listen, wait for me, will you? I want to talk to you.
Michael, my plane leaves in 2 hours. I have a cab coming.
I want you to wait, please.
I don't know.
Trying to reach Ava when I slipped and took a bad fall.
Keep moving.
I had to, otherwise the fall would have killed me. I found
I wasn't ready to die.
What happened?
It was an accident. An accident.
This is over and we get down. You still want to build that ski run?
Do you?
Yeah. Maybe more than you do.
Bobsled run.
Does it mean what I hope it means?
Yeah. How do you like it around here?
Are we staying?
For a long time.
Complete any picture on the game card and win.
I want a Whopper.
I want 10 bucks.
Instant winners, too.
I want a Coke.
Complete any picture and win.
You won.
Yeah.
Make it special.
Everybody has to
make it Burger King.
7 p.m. PM Magazine on the scene.
Watch out, cat burglars. Those dazzling diamonds may be counterfeit. They're Wellingtons. The pride and joy of Madame Wellington. We'll meet this colorful lady on our next PM magazine. Master Gardener Jerry Baker has advice on what to do now to control crabgrass, and we'll take a look at the crossover of gospel music from the church to the record charts.
Tomorrow at 7 p.m.
Together with the Luke of Detroit.